you want to look like $1 million without spending $1 million, former Miss Ethiopia Sahin Bello trains women how to look fabulous for less and find their own personal style. Please welcome Sahin. So great to have you with us today. You have a wonderful background. You were Miss Ethiopia. How did that happen and what opportunities did that provide for you?
That opportunity is amazing. And what happened was in 1988, the Ethiopians in America, which is hundreds and thousands of them, said, you know, we haven't had a pageant for 20 years because our country has been going through so much turmoil and, you know, famine and political upheaval. So they said, but beauty pageant is our tradition. Ethiopians are known for looking beautiful. So they said, we want to start that again. And they decided to have one in 1988, and they had to go back 20 years ago, 1968, find the last Miss Ethiopia, fly her from Germany to Washington, D.C., where I was crowned. And it was a very emotional time because it brought us so many memories of the good old days, so to speak.
And since then, you were able to use that platform to really bring attention to some of the issues and the situations in Ethiopia affecting the people and do some charitable work as well, right?
Absolutely. I think the doors that title opened for me for almost 20 years, I would say, I mean, until a couple years ago, I was still being flown to different cities to speak about the children in Ethiopia because we still have famine and HIV AIDS right now. Ethiopia being one of the top 5 countries with the highest HIV death rates. I think about 1 million orphans are expected in Ethiopia because of HIV AIDS. So that title has opened doors for me, even here while I was in Georgia. It was just phenomenal. I could go almost go anywhere with that title, so it was great.
Well, and one of the other things that you have done, being a former model and Miss Ethiopia, it brought you a lot of training and understanding of how to dress and how to carry yourself. And you have recently put together this wonderful, beautiful book. It's called Fabulous for Less. Look at the cover of that. Oh, that just looks, that is just so beautiful. And all the pictures throughout are of you, and beautiful pictures. What are some of the highlights in this book and things that you encourage women to do in order to streamline their shopping, maximize their money, and really maximize their own look?
I would say number one is quality is so important. Quality is so important. So the focus has to be when you go for an outfit, go for quality. And number two, know your style. Be true to yourself. The cover of Vogue shouldn't determine what you should wear or the display window at Neiman Marcus. You should look in the mirror and say, what do I look good in? And you set the trend for you.
Right.
And that's number two. And number three, when you go out there, don't let the sale determine what you should buy.
Yes, they always give you that hard sell.
Yes.
And you need to really know what you're looking for,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly. You leave your home with a list. You go to your closet. You don't start thinking about what you should buy in the store. You go to your closet and say, what is it, what I need? Is it a weekend outfit? Is it a suit? Is it a formal attire?
So you take inventory first.
Before you leave. Because when you go to the store, you're going to be swayed by the salesperson, by the music, by whatever
the
is out there.
The latest trends.
Absolutely. And you come home, and you end up with these pieces that don't go with anything, and they end up taking precious closet space and eventually collect dust.
And you really encourage women to find a particular designer or line or label that fits their style and their body type, because there are different body types. And you need to find the designer that really cuts for your body type.
Absolutely. I think that is key, because when I find a designer whose clothes I can take off the rack, whether it's a pair of jeans for the weekend or a formal black tie for a very formal occasion, that is my designer. So what happens is when the sale goes at the end of the summer or the winter, when I go, I'm just going to go to that one boutique, be done in an hour, and
you're
that's
not hitting
it.
every store.
Exactly. As long as that one designer is quality fabric, quality construction, tailoring, and then the style suits me. It radiates who I am most beautifully from the inside and keeping my authentic self at the same time.
And I can imagine that would save a lot of time.
Absolutely. Statistics says the average woman spends 146 hours a year. I think it's more
shopping?
than Shopping. That's more than she spends in working out and even probably cooking.
Oh my goodness.
So just think how many hours the women can have to do everything they want to do this new year.
I was surprised to find that you suggest that women shop only twice a year.
That's it.
Twice a year?
Yes.
When?
And I tell you why. Because the prices go 90% off. 90% off at the end of the summer and at the end of the winter. Because the retailers are saying, we're ready for the next season. Mm-hmm. We need the space. Please take them away. You're almost doing them a favor. So when we say end of the summer, that's Labor Day weekend. So that week leading to the Labor Day, that week is when they have it because they're ready for the winter. And for the winter, guess what? It is this same week we're in, leading us to Martin Luther King Jr.'s birthday. This is a magic week.
So the week to go shopping is this week.
This is it.
Get ready this weekend.
Please wait and see the show first.
Oh my goodness. And
exactly.
You really encourage women to find their colors, shop
Absolutely.
Within their season, and look for solids as well.
Lisa, colors are so beautiful. Mm-hmm. I don't care if it's a $10,000 outfit. If it is not the right color, it can't do the magic.
Mm-hmm.
It's got to be the right color. Now, I would suggest that everybody gets their color analyzed, unless they're gifted naturally.
Mm-hmm.
Some people just know it, but some people really have absolutely no idea. Now, if they cannot afford to pay money for a color analyst, what they could do is there is a book called Color Me Beautiful,
yes.
which is, I think, gives people the four different mm-hmm. seasons. It helps you know what colors you favor.
And then take those colors with you while you're shopping.
Every day.
Yes.
Yeah, whether you buy makeup or clothes.